Today on the Doug and Lisa Show, a big summer surprise will be revealed at the end of the show, but first, Doug and Lisa get fancy at the Okanagan Best of Spring Varietals, some updates with former guests, and a special appearance from the writers, producers, and a couple of cast members from the original musical, The Raft of the Medusa.
Hello and welcome to the fancy episode of the DL Show. Oh, very nice, very fancy. Yep. So, we're all dressed up because we're going to a fancy wine event coming up on the show. And we've got a...
announcement to make.
A fancy announcement to make. So, we just thought we'd carry that over for the whole show. But we kind of forgot to tell our guests.
So. Nobody got the memo.
So, they're going to show up and... they'll just have to...
We're just going to look fancier than them.
They'll just have to bask in our glow.
We should have, like, higher seats so we can look down on them in our fancy clothes.
We already do.
Oh, yeah. Perfect.
All right. So that fancy announcement coming up. We've got lots of great guests on today's show. But first, should we head off to the...
The Best of Spring Varietals.
Wine.
Doug, take it easy.
Look who's talking. Look at us all dressed up.
I showered today.
Awesome. Sure, hold the thing. Best of Varietal Awards 2015 for the Okanagan Spring Wine Festival. This room is packed.
It is packed full of winemakers from around BC. Is that right, BC?
Yeah, all across BC.
And we're finding out which ones are the best. So
we're gonna check out some of the best wines. And also, we want to find out a little bit of the inside scoop.
We always like to find the story behind the winery or cidery or brewery, and tonight we're going to find out some weird, quirky, unusual facts about the wineries that nobody else knows.
But now they'll know.
Well, now that you guys will know because of us.
So you're welcome.
Yeah. Well, we have our hands full of awards from Inniskillen. Derek, congratulations.
Thank you.
We're going around asking people kind of a weird or quirky or unique thing about your winery that nobody would know.
That no one would know. Well, our name comes from the Inniskillen Fusiliers from the War of 1812, Colonel Cooper. How's that?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
I was guessing that it was an Okanagan name.
No, a drive from an Irish regiment over. It started in Ontario, and then the name transpired over here. The original property that we started off in Ontario was land given to Colonel Cooper for his duties in the war, and he named it after the regiment. So then when it was purchased for the winery, they kept the name.
Pinot Noir is really tough to grow, as everybody knows. So basically at 50th Parallel, we've got a site there that's really incredible, which is really, really cool. We've got Grant Stanley, great winemaker. And the one thing that you guys don't know is that actually I cut all my hair off at harvest and put it into the Pinot Noir to make the Pinot. So that's why it's so fabulous. So come see me shaved during harvest.
This is what's really crazy. I can't believe you actually just talked about hair, because the quirky thing, and this is totally true, I do all the HR as events and all the things of 50th Parallel. The thing about 50th Parallel, from proprietor to winemaker and assistant, in their contracts, there is a hair clause.
We do have a hair clause.
Because they all have this gorgeous, thick, luscious hair, and it's hot and it's sexy, and let's face it, glamour farmers, we need to see nice hair when we farm. So that's kind of quirky, and they all have great hair at 50.
So nobody cuts their hair off and puts it. There's a contract, a hair contract, so nobody's allowed to cut their hair. So nobody would know
that. Yeah, I can apply.
Totally true.
Is my hair long enough?
You're in, you're out.
Yeah. You're out. Get out of here, Doug. You see you later.
You're on the fence.
You are so in, and we're going to have Pinot Gris with that hair.
First off, congratulations on your stack of awards.
Oh, very excited. Thank you so much. Great evening.
But you're one of the longest wineries. It's been around in the valley a long, long time. There must be something quirky, unusual, weird that people just don't know about Wild Goose.
You know what? Two brothers in the industry, still together, making wines.
For
isn't
how
that something? 25 years now.
25 years, two brothers? Yeah. Did you get along with you?
Any fights? I would kill my sister.
We do have some, but we keep them, in this wine cellar only. You know, after my dad had purchased the property, he went back to see what he had spent all his money on, and he followed a little cow trail into a forested area, and there was about 150 Canada geese feeding in a green patch, and he just spooked them up. And you don't usually get too close to geese, and they rose up and flew to the north, and that was the name, Wild Goose Vineyards.
Sound like he went on a wild goose chase.
Well, you know what, sometimes.
It was a wild goose chase to find the wild geese.
That's right, yes. It took us a while to find just the perfect spot, let me tell you.
We are now with Judy from Therapy, and you have an award there.
Yes, we just won a finalist for our Pink Floyd 2014.
What we're trying to find out is something that people might not know about the winery. Is something quirky, unusual, funny little story?
Well, actually, I started there July 1st, actually, and I came from dirty laundry. So the industry joke was, after 9 years of dirty laundry, Judy leaves for therapy. And
hilarious.
It's an absolutely stunning facility, and we've got lots of great things coming up. All the names are very quirky. We have Freud's Ego, the Freudian Sip, our Freudified, which is a fortified wine, the Pink Freud, of course, which just won an award. We've got new labels coming up now. It's all really pretty exciting.
I'm going to give you back your plaque.
Yeah, thank you.
I'll trade it for some wine.
Yeah, no, and it was actually a doctor that came into the winery that came up with that suggestion many years ago about doing, after the band Pink Floyd.
Yeah.
And definitely people seem to love our little cartoon Freud person who's on many of our labels, and yeah, it's a huge hit.
Well, I love how when you go out to people's houses, like your friend's house, and someone's like, I want some therapy. I'm like, yeah, I could use some therapy, and they pull out a bottle of your winery. So it's very catchy.
Yeah, it's a lot of fun to work at events. People actually do rush to my table saying they need therapy.
Que sera, sera. Look at that.
I'm not singing.
You don't have to sing. You've got the award. You don't have to sing. We're singing to you. My longtime friend, Crystal Lee McWatersbond, with your fabulous best Syrah Shiraz.
I know, we're super excited. We've just started producing Syrah. Very small production, only 100 cases. So to win tonight is like amazing. So we're very
excited. Which winery is this? Because you've been around the wine industry for a little while.
I've been around. That makes me sound old.
The wine industry for a little while.
Okay, so yes, Time Estate Winery is our new winery. We're just under construction on Black Sage Road. But you're right, we have been around for a while. So we've been growing since 1993. So we really were one of the first wineries to plant along the bench in Black Sage. So we've been growing for a while, and we figure, you know what? It's about time to do our own thing again. So it's about time and place, and we know what the vineyard gives us. And Dick Cleaver, our viticulturalist, obviously does a great job with Syrah, so we're pretty excited.
What is it that sets yours apart?
Oh, you know what? I think it's the age of the vines, really, right? We're growing in basically sand, and we've got such great terroir, the sunlight, and just the aspect. And Dick does such a great job for us in the vineyard that lots of nice spice characteristic to it. So
you're making me thirsty.
I know. We need to get you some.
Now, one thing that we're doing today is we want to find out from some of the wineries something quirky, unusual, different, something that people might not know.
Something you might not know is that we're not new, right? Most people haven't heard about Time, but really we've been doing this a long time. My dad's been in the industry for 50 years. I've been doing this for 30 years. I made my first wine when I was 9. So you might not have heard of Time Estate Winery, but we've been doing it a while. And when we first planted our vineyard, it was the single largest planting in all of Canada. And people thought we were really crazy because we planted Merlot, Syrah, Cabernet Sauvignon, Cabernet Franc. And it sounds funny now, but people thought that you couldn't grow those varieties in British Columbia. But I think we proved them wrong. Trailblazer right here.
My question for you is, what are you drinking there?
I have a little Syrah in my glass, of course.
Yeah,
it's got to celebrate. So
exactly.
It's great. Yeah.
Awesome. Okay, so this is the Mystic River.
Mystic River.
Gewurz, the award-winning. Roland said we had to try this, right?
Yes. What do you do with white wine to make it look fancy? Like, do you squish it?
Swirl it around and smell it. I missed my mouth with that sip.
Lots of quirky things happening all the time.
Love it. Well, thank you guys so much, and congratulations.
Thank you so much. It's a pleasure. Thank you.
That was.
That is a wrap for Doug and Lisa's Taste of the Tasting.
Taste of the Best of the Awards. So if you want to find out all the complete list of the winners, go to winefestivals.com, and there it will be in all its very lengthy glory, because there's a lot of wineries, a lot of really deserving wineries.
And stay up to date with our Facebook postings, facebook.com/Doug and Lisa Show.
Oh, that's right. Top secret project coming up soon. Well, not top secret. Not even really secret. Anyway, we'll tell you about it later.
We will.
What a great bunch of people, eh? Like, the winemakers are just so passionate about what they're doing. It's always exciting to meet people that just love what they're doing and put so much care and attention into it.
You just loved it because you tried every single one.
I did not try every single one. There was a lot. I got the full list.
I carried him on my back.
And that's why your back's sore.
That is why my back's sore, yes.
So you might probably notice the question marks up there. That's like our riddle. No, it's not a riddle, because we're not going to give you any clues. But it is to do with our top secret announcement. And it's black and white, like us.
I know.
It's a fancy question mark.
It is killing me inside. I want to tell... But we'll wait until the
end of the show. But first up, our first set of guests, you probably recognize them if you watched our first episode. It's a little bit of a flashback.
We've got
the Paddler Boys, Kerry Mizler, Bob Purdy. They've made an incredible movie, and it's getting all kinds of opportunities to be seen all across Canada, picking up some awards, and they're going to be here in a second to tell us all about it.
Feels like deja vu.
This is deja vu. We've got Bob and Kerry from the Paddler movie.
The last couple of months have just been a ride and a half. What an amazing journey.
Well, you guys started, if you didn't see our first show with them, they were just releasing the Paddler movie here in Kelowna. But since then, do you want to tell us a bit about what's happened with that movie?
Yeah, it's the premiere was just off the hook. We had about 400 or 500 people at the premiere here in Kelowna. And then it's shown at the Canada International Film Festival, where it won an award of excellence, which was really cool. That happened a couple of weeks after it was released. And it's currently showing on the LA Cinefest online down in LA, and it will be showing as part of the Vancouver International Mountain Film Festival in June and the Toronto Beach Festival in July. So it's definitely getting some traction.
Those are just the ones we've submitted to so far, so we're going to keep submitting, but it actually costs money every time you submit to these film festivals. So we'll just keep submitting and keep getting accepted and see what happens. With this movie we started, I got the initial funding to start the movie, and then we ran out of money, so we did a Kickstarter campaign. We were successful with the Kickstarter campaign, and then shortly after that, when the movie was finished, we had our first movie premiere here. It was successful, and then we got approached about the Canada International Film Festival Awards, and they let us know that we had won the 2015 Award of Excellence.
Wow.
So right off the bat, it's just like one thing after another.
So why are people watching the movie? What about it is making
Bob's
film?
In it.
Because Bob!
That's why we got him back to be able to watch our show.
You know, the response we've had to the film has just been incredible. Probably the best example I could give you is the showing we did in Tofino. After the movie, there was a lineup of people waiting to chat, you know, as they left the movie. And there was one woman there that she waited for quite a long time. And she came up to me and shook my hand and introduced herself, and she would not let go of my hand. And she said, I really have to thank you for putting this film together. It turns out she's a cleaner, a maid, and she said, I'm going home right from here and I'm going to go through my entire cleaning supplies, and the ones that are not environmentally friendly I'm going to dispose of, and I'm going to replace them with something that's better.
And that was your point, right? We wanted to help people make a difference in how they live on the planet, right?
Yeah, that's been my message personally with Paddle for the Planet since I started in 2011. That's the message we put out there all the time, is we need to change the way we're living on the planet. And to see those things actually happen, we have a long ways to go, don't get me wrong, but there have been some pretty incredibly cool things happen over the last four years and a bit that I've been doing this, and it gives me fuel to keep going.
Are you, speaking of fuel, are you still out there paddling?
Yeah, what paddling day are you on now?
Yeah.
1,582.
What was ours?
You guys were...
We did one.
That was the end of year four paddle. Kudos to you guys for coming out in the cold. That was such a fun day.
That was really fun. What is your guys' goal of where you'd like this to get to?
We're going to keep submitting to as many festivals as we can.
Is there one particular one that's like, that's my goal, I want that one?
The Palm Springs International Film Festival would be really cool.
Yeah.
My mom and dad live in California, so it's actually really close to where they live.
It's convenient.
It's like 50 miles from their place, so if it got into there and they were able to come there and check it out, it would just be awesome. And just another note on the Tofino thing, is like I had been going there since I was 18 years old, just on different surfing trips every year until now. And in Tofino, the word travels fast because it's a really small community. you know, they'll push people out if they don't like them. They've been so receptive to us over the years and like helped out with accommodation and you know, just the most amazing people down there for sure. And I was at the premiere there, was probably one of the coolest things I've ever seen, because it was like the whole community. And they had a welcoming ceremony, an Aboriginal welcoming ceremony for us. And just all the people that, like Bob said, after how happy they were about the film.
Yeah, everyone was coming together.
Yeah, it was really cool to be involved in that. So just things like that, that would never, you would never really, never have that happen on a different job or a different scenario. So that's really cool, is the people that you get to meet.
And an influence.
Yeah.
That's so great, guys. It's so exciting. It must be a fantastic journey. Thanks for coming in and giving us an update, and you know, let us know about Palm Springs. Maybe we can go down there and...
Just like this?
Yeah.
You guys didn't get the memo with the outfits. Yeah, let's go and play.
Okay.
And Sundance. You know, we got to get Robert Redford, you know, so...
Yeah. Yeah. Done. You guys are looking for a date. Doug's available.
thanks very much for coming in, and thanks for what you guys are doing to make a difference.
Yeah.
And for people who haven't seen your guys' movie, how did they see it?
Currently, the movie has just signed a distribution deal, actually. So we are in the process of... they're getting the process out there with different networks, television stations, online... on demand stuff, and right now you can watch it on Vimeo on demand.
Oh, okay.
Just search for The Paddler on Vimeo on demand.
Great. Well, thanks so much, you guys, and congratulations on all your success.
Thanks.
Thanks so much for having us, and kudos on the show. You know, like you mentioned earlier, we were on your first show. It's so great to watch the progress. Very, very cool.
We're getting the hang of it.
It's awesome.
So much. Are we though? So the Paddler movie has been accepted into the Los Angeles Cinefest, but they need your help.
Your help, that's right.
Did you vote?
I haven't voted yet. I'm going to do that the second that we're off the air. They just told us about it.
Well, I voted already. That's how fast I am on my phone.
She's got her phone. She's always on the phone. lacinefest.weebly.com/April.
Yeah. And they make it really easy to find.
Really easy to find. But if you go to lacinefest.weebly.com,
/April.
Google like put it in there, you'll find it. It's easy to vote. They need your help. It would be amazing to see a locally made movie get that kind of attention, and it's such an important cause.
Exactly.
So it's really super cool to support them.
It is cool, even how far they've gotten right now. Yeah. With, you know, it just shows that we have a shift in our mindsets about the environment and how important it is.
Very important.
So thanks, guys. And another person who's kind of riding the wave of the Paddler movie, like that.
I like that. That's good.
Lisa Rummel, she was the graphic designer that designed the poster of the Paddler movie.
She's going to come on and talk about some more of her art, and we'll get a chance to meet the artist behind the poster.
We're back with Lisa Rummel, and she is the artist behind the Paddler movie.
Welcome, Lisa. This is fantastic.
Hi. Thank you.
I'm really... I'm distracted by the paintings over there behind you, because I'm pretty sure I've been on that beach. Is that modeled after the Tofino Lodge?
Yes.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, I should have put the guys in the wetsuit, but...
Yeah, nobody surfs there without a wetsuit.
Surfing. And the other painting there is the background image that I painted for the Paddler movie poster.
Right.
I'm a digital artist for one thing, so I do all my painting with a pen tablet, and the computer acts as a canvas. So that's all hand-painted with my computer. And I also just seem to be able to sort of channel, as artists do, the information required. And I just kind of went with the flow on this painting, and it turns out there's an actual scene in the movie that I didn't know before the hand that it looked exactly like it.
Wow.
There's been so much momentum building from the Paddler movie since the last time we talked to Bob and Carrie, the movie just being released here in Kelowna, and now just to know that your artwork is kind of getting out there, how does that feel?
It feels awesome. I really appreciate Carrie's and Bob's offer to request to do the work, and I'm grateful for that. And the images that you see here and many others are available for sale on my website at www.hadawai.com. That's H-A-D-O-W-A-I.
So are they all surfers?
Not everything is surfing. I do have a white buffalo galloping. It's a long panorama. I painted that for a friend of mine. He's a totem animal. He was into sweat lodge ceremony. His totem animal was the white buffalo. And I do have Most of it's surf oriented right now.
Oh, cool.
Because my company, I'm on the verge of growing it into water sport graphics and these sorts of things. So
Lisa's got some big stuff in store that she can't fully tell us just yet. It's a secret, but it's very interesting what she's doing.
Now, you came out when we went paddling with Bob, but somehow you stayed very dry.
Yeah, what was up with that?
You chickened out.
Yeah, it was because I just got my hair done for the premiere and I had an art show and somebody called me out on Facebook.
I
so
did.
I couldn't really deny that one.
I called you. What did I say to you? Post a picture of a chicken.
Yes.
And then she came the next day. So, you know, she's game for anything. So let's go to the lake and go paddleboarding again with that guy.
Sweet.
And what's in store for your future?
She can't tell us.
Without telling you that what's happening.
That's the big news.
I know that, but we're going to tell that on another show, and it's going to be a very big release.
But she's got nothing. They can't.
Are you going to speak for her, Doug?
No, go ahead. Go ahead. Tell us.
In store for my future in...
Like, what's
let me read your
passion.
Palm. Let me see what's in store for your future.
There's a lot of that. Wow, you're going to have forever. Awesome. Lots of ideas.
Yes, I do.
I guess what I meant to say is what keeps your passion alive for artwork? Like, what makes you want to do it?
I love being in sort of in the flow of creation, of the creative process. I liked even when I'm doing logo designs or any of these sorts of things, I really enjoy connecting with my client and kind of getting an impression of what it is that they would like to see and being able to make inspired ideas come to life. And I love seeing the joy, like the excitement on their face when they see it. And Carrie was really pleased with this poster that I created for him.
I think anybody would be you're very talented.
See, that was a much better question.
Thanks, Doug. Maybe you should write my questions before we start.
No, because you have to write mine up before we start usually. Okay, sorry.
Well, thank you so much, Lisa.
Yeah,
and
thank
some
you
big
for
things
me.
In store for you. You know, and we can't wait to share that news with everybody.
Me too, very excited.
That was cool. I love that picture, that painting of the surfers at Tofino.
I know. I should get some money from that because they used my...
Well, that's your silhouette.
That's my silhouette, yeah.
Right. Of course. Of course it is. Now, you've got a update from another former guest as well. It's like flashback fever on today's show.
Flashback fever, yeah. And I also got a tour of a new pub in Kelowna
right.
That is literally a game changer because they like to game there.
So. You're just like full of puns tonight. That's awesome.
Okay, so you might recognize this face here. Mark Jennings Bates was on one of our earlier shows for Doug and Lisa. And you've kind of been on a little bit of an adventure.
We're flying whirligigs. We're learning to fly gyroplanes. They're so cool.
For anyone that doesn't know, what is a gyroplane?
You know, Andre had no idea before we started taking lessons.
I had no clue. It's kind of a hybrid. It's a helicopter fixed wing. It's in between a helicopter and a fixed wing.
Sounds dangerous.
No, not at all, no. No, everyone that's gone up has come down again.
Well,
it's 100% successful.
That's good, knock on wood, right? Why are you guys doing this?
It's a big adventure. I'm going to try and fly around the world with one, ultimately. And we're working with a great company out of Eastern Canada, actually, called AirPro Gyro, so they're helping us out. It's so cool.
And what made you get involved here?
Mark dragged me in. I'm doing business all the time. Mark is an adventurer. I can't help myself. He dragged me in and... He's trying to get onto my business side too, so we're making a good team.
How does your wife feel about this new adventure?
I'm working on that. I haven't seen her for a few weeks. She's coming here actually a little later, so I'm going to find out what she's thinking. But I think she's all right.
Okay, why? Why are you doing this?
Oh, you know what? I think the next big adventure is totally cool. Nobody has flown a gyroplane around the world, so we figured we would try and fly a gyroplane around the world. So first thing is, step one, is learn to fly a gyroplane. That's very important.
And then find someone else that is willing to come along for the adventure. That's
well,
what you
totally.
Yeah, it won't be my wife. That's why Mark is going to be my partner.
Oh, so you guys will be like, you'll be his wife in the sky.
I'm afraid he will be, yeah.
Oh, he will be. I like that. He switched. That's good. So, and are you still going to do that underwater tricycle thing? Because on our show a while back, he said that he was going to be trying the underwater.
Yes. I've had a problem, but I've solved it. I couldn't find a swimming pool with a flat bottom, so Victoria has one set aside for me. So I'm going to have to go to Victoria and do it in Victoria.
Tell them what you're going to do.
We're going to ride a unicycle 2.5 kilometers underwater.
It's funny because when he came on the show, he was talking about how he's going to do that. And he thought he'd be the first person, but then I guess some people just in 1 year broke the record.
Yeah, I thought I'd have to do 50 meters and now it's 2.5 kilometers.
I actually watched some videos online. It's pretty funny to watch.
Oh, it's totally boring.
And I can be your scuba diver?
Please, it would be great.
All right, update from Mark Jennings Bates, who was on episode 2 of Doug and Lisa. And we're actually somewhere familiar to Mark, too, because not only is Mark a crazy, adventurous, globetrotting crazy person, in this building here are his sons, who have just opened up their own pub.
They have too. I am so proud of them.
Yeah, and tell us about, show the sign here, Dave. So it says, "What would Thor do?" So
I'm reading this.
I know.
He would slay ice giants. He would feast all night. Or he would drink till dawn.
It's a Viking bar. That's how you explain it. This is a Viking bar.
It's a nerd bar.
Let's go check it out. And Mark, you can give me a tour, and we can go see your boys.
Hello.
And anybody back here? Oh, look who it is. Your little boys are hard at work. That's so cute. How does that feel as a dad to have your boys owning a restaurant and working together so nicely?
It's so cool, isn't it? And in fact, at the front is Lee's wife and Matt's girlfriend.
How does everybody get along?
Oh, they just do. I think it's great. And look at that. That generation is actually doing so well. It's brilliant.
They are working.
They are.
One sentence to get people to come to this bar, what would you say?
No sports.
No sports. See? Vikings
nerd
only.
Bar.
Nerd bar.
Hey, Lee, have you got any Britney Spears CDs?
Huh?
Have you got any Britney Spears CDs?
No.
No, okay.
Well, let's go to the front and see what this is all about while these guys get busy cooking. Oh, look at this bathroom. Warriors, this is the men. And shield maidens is the ladies. I'm looking at the bathrooms. Oh, look who it is. Siobhan, so you are the lady behind the man. Let's go in the light so you're not so dark. Okay, so Siobhan is Lee's wife, and tell us about this bar.
Well, we got really tired of not having anywhere to go, drink beer, eat good food that's not overpriced, and not have to worry about watching sports, listening to sports fans, or, you know, getting looked at if we want to play a board game. As you can tell, tonight is a Canucks night.
And nobody here knows.
Nobody's watching. This is what we like to call our D&D dungeon. So everybody who wants to come in and spend like 4 hours playing a D&D campaign can just come here and be forgotten about for a while.
Where'd you guys get all these games from?
A lot of them were our own, and then we had a lot of people donate some, and it keeps getting bigger every day. So
that is so good. Well, let's have a look at some of these things. Oh my gosh, is that a Ouija board? It's saying you will watch the Doug and Lisa show, and you will come to this pub in that order. What do Vikings drink?
Well, Vikings drink
meat. It's only fitting that she wears her Viking hat. There we go. This is what the bar is all about. So what do you have on tap?
We have Odin's Gift from Odin Brewing in Seattle. We have Red Racer IPA from Central City. We have Big Surf Lager from here in the Okanagan, and Fire Hall Stout also from here in Oliver, and Marydale Cider. Yeah, Marydale Cider from the island. So
it's so different, right? You guys don't really have any competition here.
Not really, because nobody's doing the same thing we're doing. So.
Well, I think it's so awesome that you guys are, you know, you had a problem, you found a solution, and now you guys have a place to geek it out with some board games and some good beer.
And a really sweet bar.
It is a sweet bar. Let's have a look at this dragon.
I had a grumpy old craftsman that I used to serve coffee to at Starbucks, and I told him that I wanted a slightly ship-shaped bar, and he came in and did the whole thing.
That is amazing. What's his name?
Silvio.
Silvio, you did good. How's business been so far?
Pretty good. Pretty steady. We found all the nerds and brought them in.
So. You did. It looks like an awesome crowd around here, and it's a warm, inviting place to be.
We're not pushing people out when they're done eating or having a drink, or we're not like shoving them the bill and being like,
TikTok people.
Exactly.
How do you guys all get along when you guys live and work together?
We don't always. But that's the same as anything, I guess. We do love each other. We get along most of the time. And it's nice to know that you have to trust those people and that they have your back as much as you have theirs. So.
Because you guys all want the same thing, right?
We all want to succeed and we all want to work for ourselves. So.
Awesome. Any tips for people that want to follow in your footsteps in terms of having a vision and then making it a reality? Because sometimes people think it's too hard to start a business.
It is hard. And you are probably going to doubt yourself, and you will probably think it fail, and it might, but you're never going to know unless you try.
Now, there are a lot of people behind the scenes that I think should be in front of the camera.
Absolutely.
And one of those people...
Over there and over there.
Yeah, actually, everyone behind these cameras is somebody you will see in front of the camera. Right now, we're going to be featuring Dave at camera two.
That's right, our floor director, Dave. He's got an interesting alter ego that comes out, unique alter ego that sometimes comes out. His name is Franz.
Franz, and he's going to be giving us some Okanagan life hacks, so to make your life easier. Is he France French or Quebec French?
No.
No.
We'll let the audience decide.
We'll let the audience decide. All right, let's roll that clip.
Oh, welcome, my friends. This is Okanagan X. Je suis France Dubré. Today, the egg is the grilled cheese on the toaster. We are going to enjoy this wine, the Sauvignon Blanc, the Michelin Ale with this egg. Oh, c'est bon. Oh. For this egg, we will need the cheese, le fromage, le pain, the bread, a toaster. Oh, now this cooking is in the toaster.
Oh, it's not going to burn. It's good.
Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh. Come on, get out of here. Oh, no. It's going to take. Parfait. C'est bon. Au revoir. Au revoir.
Careful with that toast, Franz.
Learn something new every day.
Yeah, you
know. Not sure how helpful that is, but okay. Now, another behind-the-scenes character around here is our graphic designer.
Morgan. Guten Morgen.
Guten Morgen, and that is the name of the segment. Well, we sent him, we flew him.
Yeah,
no expenses spared.
Budget.
No, he was on holidays in New Zealand, and we said, hey, while you're there.
We piggybacked him.
We piggybacked.
We said, hey, we got some dares for you, so get a camera out here, GoPro, which is good. And we sent him on a few challenges. So the first one we're gonna see today is the luge.
Luging.
Hello, Doug and Lisa. Shaw TV and the Okanagan. It's Morgan Summerskill, the graphic designer for the Doug and Lisa Show. I'm in New Zealand, beautiful Queenstown. And my challenge for today is to take this luge. Doug and Lisa, I recommend that to anybody coming to New Zealand and visiting Queenstown. Morgan Summerskill signing out. Till next time, motion and graphic designer. See you next time.
You know, we're always looking for fresh talent here at the Doug and Lisa Show.
Yes, we are. And as an intern, you know, in the show, we really like to...
challenge people.
Yeah.
Use their skills.
We don't make them get us coffee. We like to, you know, harness creativity here.
Speaking of coffee.
We believe in giving you the freedom to succeed in a competitive marketplace.
But not too much freedom.
Grab her, Kristen.
Seriously, Lisa, I'm like really thirsty.
So if you're a team player and love to have fun,
you will be a shoo-in for the job.
All jokes aside, come and have fun with us.
Yes, this summer.
This summer, it's gonna be exciting.
And that's part of the
big question mark. What is the question?
What
is the answer?
What are we gonna do this summer?
Oh, it's such a surprise.
It's such a surprise. We're gonna keep you, you know.
Edge of their seat, suspense.
Yeah, and we're gonna reveal that secret question that's been burning in everybody's minds at the end of the show. But first...
But we're sending T, the intern, out onto the streets, trying to incorporate music lyrics into everyday conversation. It's kind of like talking to her.
Out on the boardwalk, out in the sun, out on the boardwalk, we'll be having some fun. On the boardwalk, boardwalk. Hey! Do you like my hair? Hey, wait, I had more to say. Peek-a-boo. Hi, I'm Taylor. Can you guess how many music lyrics are in this video?
You ain't nothing but a hound dog.
Hello.
Hi.
Is it me you're looking for?
I wasn't, but maybe I am now.
Thought so. Where'd you get that selfie stick? Hello.
Hi.
I love you. Won't you tell me your name?
Rob.
Is this for me?
No.
Oh. Can I have it?
No.
Take me to church. Hey, guys. I left a good job in the city.
You lost a good job in the city?
I was fired. Are you leaving on a jet plane?
No.
I think you are.
I'm not. You must have done something very serious to be fired.
I'm on a boat.
You're on a Sea-Doo.
Oh, too many selfies.
Too many selfies. Oh.
Lisa, where are you? I'm all about that bass.
Are you?
I am. No trouble.
No trouble?
None. You got a fast car, and I got a ticket to anywhere.
Doesn't look like you're gonna get very far with that leash.
Lisa, give me one good reason to stay here, or I'll turn right back around. You can see me turning. Let's give them something to talk about.
What are you doing with a leash on your back?
Why are you on the leash?
All interns are on a leash.
Is that a safety thing?
Don't all interns have a leash?
No. I know husbands do.
If you would like to be an intern on the Doug and Lisa Show, email us at thedougandlisashow@gmail.com. Take me to Shaw Studios!
Up next on the show, this is something I'm super excited about. A brand new musical, locally written and produced. It's called Raft of the Medusa, and here is just a little taste of it.
From the delirium of joy, we fell into profound despondency and grief. We envied the fate of those whom we had seen perish at our sides. And we said to ourselves, when we shall be destitute of everything, and our strength begins to forsake us, we will wrap ourselves up as best we can. We will lay ourselves down on this platform, the scene of so much suffering. And there we will await death with resignation. It's cold tonight. And all that's left for me to do is sleep lost at sea. There's no one watching me. This was to be a new beginning in Senegal for me, where we could start again. Not this tragic end. I wait for death and hope that it takes me, and I know that it won't be long. In all of the blood we shed for our own lives, look around, everyone's gone. Damn you, damn you, damn you, Medusa. We must save ourselves. Damn.
That was incredible. So fantastic.
I'm gonna have that in my head for the rest of my life, I think.
Excellent.
That's the goal.
That is the goal.
So what character are you playing there, Pat?
I play the Medusa doctor. I'm the surgeon on the ship, who is one of the man who wrote the actual narrative that the story is based on, and one of the 15 that survived off the raft.
Okay, so let's talk about this for a second. For people that are new to this whole thing, it's based on a true story. Can you guys give us like a quick little Cole's Notes version of the story?
Yeah, absolutely. So it's based on a true account of one of the worst naval disasters of the 19th century. The French frigate Medusa ran aground off the west coast of Africa, and through the course of things, wasn't enough room in the lifeboat, so they set 150 people on a makeshift raft, and they ended up getting cast adrift.
Wow.
2 weeks later, 15 people were left alive on the raft.
Out of how many?
Out of 150.
Wow. So that's a pretty heavy rate of attrition.
How many
that's
men right. and women?
So there were only a handful of women and mostly men on board. And then about 2 years later, a famous artist in France, Theodore Géricault, discovered this story, this narrative that Henri Savigny, the doctor, had written, and he embarked on his masterpiece, which is called The Raft of the Medusa. Mm-hmm.
So the painting is like iconic in art history, and it's huge. The Raft of the Medusa is a gigantic painting.
Gigantic painting.
And it had a real effect in society when it first released. It was like a blockbuster.
It really was. He took it on tour, in fact, but it was shunned in Paris, where he opened in the Salon, and they were like, no, this is bad. It's, you know, a real black eye to the king, and so he took it to England, and they thought it was great. But yeah, it's 23 feet wide by 16 feet high, and it hangs in the Louvre, and it's actually one of the most visited paintings in the Louvre today.
When Doug said that you guys were coming, and he said Medusa, I was thinking, like, the snake hair, that's the Medusa, but this is completely different.
Completely different. A lot of people mistake that, yeah, and that's the name of the ship. And part of our, you know, we're hoping to do is help educate people about the story and to come out, you know, what are they going to see at this show, and to get, let them know that the music is, you know, it's rock music, and it's accessible, and it's a great story, and it's not all dark, and it's not all shipwreck. There's a love story and, you know, other surprises along the way.
To think that you've actually written an entire musical, that's an astonishing thing.
A big accomplishment.
Daunting, to say the least.
It must have been.
Really, yeah.
What did it take to create this?
4 years of actual work.
Wow.
The concept has been around for 20.
Better than 20
years.
Really?
20 years, yeah.
Yeah.
What advice would you have for people that are wanting to follow your path and, like, you know,
follow through with the plan to write it.
Yeah, because everybody's got these big dreams.
I would say fear not. Just go for it. I mean, what it turns out like is all subject to opinion anyway. If it feels right and you want to do it, do it. I mean, it's really nothing stopping you.
So from when you guys first started writing to right now when you're actually seeing it come alive, is it what you kind of pictured it to be?
It is. It's really, really close to the vision so far. We've been really lucky. We have an excellent cast, 22 people from throughout the Okanagan Valley. Some of the A-list cast that play in, you know, some of the best shows you see around the valley. Familiar voices, for sure. And, you know, the vision is coming together. Everybody's really behind trying to make the show what's written on the paper right now. The script is working. And it's a full-length show. It's a big, large ensemble cast, and, you know, it's going to be really epic. And that's the part, as Pat said, you know, everybody said, well, maybe you should start with a two-person show, and maybe you should pick a subject that isn't quite so difficult to handle. And you know, here we are.
Go higher. Go home.
Why not?
But like you said, if it doesn't ignite your passion, you're not going to have the passion to see it to the end.
That's true.
Because it is such an incredible amount of work.
And you can't play it safe with this kind of thing, in the creative arts and things like that. You have to just go for it.
And it's a learning curve, too. I mean, we'll learn things this time that the next time, should there be one, right?
It'll be a bigger ship.
That's right. That's right. That's right. We're going to include the woman with the snakes in her head.
Hey,
that's what we're going to do.
Can I audition?
I was going to say, you're talking about the cast coming out. I recognize some of the names, of course, that are involved in it. Well, that must be exciting for performers to have the chance to put their stamp on a role that's never been seen by anybody before.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, from doing a lot of theater shows, you kind of can cheat. You can see who on Broadway did it and how did they interpret the role and how am I going to do that. And you can learn a lot of lines, mannerisms, even how to stand by doing that. There's no cheat sheets for this show. We have no video to look at. Everything we're doing, we have to invent. So the cast actually has to go away and create a backstory for each of their characters. They have to research them and learn about them. So that's been really neat to see happen and
that's
watch these guys.
I wouldn't have never even thought of that, but now that you said it, that's really interesting.
And we're getting to know these characters the same time they are. We don't know these people.
Right. Mm-hmm.
So we're starting to see it come together and form, and you see it start seeing the personality traits of each character now, and it's exciting to see it come to life.
You're going to have a band performing?
Yes, a six-piece live rock band to get us through the whole show, and musical director to keep it on track.
And it's all coming together pretty quickly. July, you've got your premiere.
July 24th is the Red Carpet Gala premiere, and we'll have all kinds of entertainment inside and out. You know, it'll be
we might be there.
We will be there. Just exactly.
You might be dressed just like that.
Yeah, just wear that.
And helping us to really bring out the red carpet and the world premiere. And it truly will be a world premiere, but one's the word on that. We've got a little more
close
to release. We're real close. Yeah.
When you guys were singing earlier, a lady in the background was saying, it sounds like it's like Broadway, like the talent. I mean, just for you guys being here, I'm really excited to see you, the rest of the cast and what you guys have.
Oh, well, we get to see some more of the cast.
When?
Right away. We're right now. Neville and Ashley are going to be here. Your old pal Ashley is here.
Ashley Atkinson and Neville Bowman.
I didn't know that.
It's okay. It'll be good.
It'll be good.
She's fantastic. Fantastic performer. We love Ashley. She's a great singer.
I grew up with Ashley, and she actually lived down the street from me. And I auditioned for many things as a child. I've stayed away from theater because of Ashley. Because Ashley is amazing. She's gorgeous. She's so talented. This beautiful voice. And the 2 years I did musical theater, she was Cinderella and Anne of Green Gables. And I think I played a curtain or
a bush. But the best darn curtain they ever
best
saw.
Curtain you ever seen.
It's curtains for you, kid. All right, so we're going to go to that right
very
away.
Very excited. That's great news. Awesome. Well, thank you guys so much.
Thanks so much for having us.
For you guys.
There's something about her like I've never seen before. Though I barely know your name, this doesn't feel strange here with you tonight.
The way he looks at me,
I'm too afraid to open the door. Could this be? How could this be love? Can it be? How can this be love? There's a duty to my family.
Fantastic, guys.
Thank Amazing.
You. Thank you so much for coming in and singing for us. It's kind of like old home week a little bit for us, because Neville's killed me on stage, or at least
Many
beat me
times.
Up on stage
Many
several times.
Yes.
And you guys have a little theatrical history.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Ashley.
Uh-oh. I shouldn't have brought that up.
Thanks for bringing it up. Years of counseling I've gotten over. Just kidding. Ashley, when we were little, we were actually in a lot of plays together. She might not know it because I was actually like behind the curtains while she was the lead.
Tree number three?
She was, yeah. I was tree number three, and she's like, I'm Anne of Green Gables.
I do remember. I'm sorry.
Well, no, well obviously you each found your niche. You can talk and she can sing.
Oh, I can talk. And this girl's got some lungs in her. You guys are amazing, absolutely beautiful voices.
So what is it like to be a part of a brand new original musical like this?
It's a very exciting process. You know, it's a lot of us in the creative world always talk about doing these two things, this process, but Randall and Pat are two people I know who've actually gone ahead and done it. So credit to them. And thanks to having us be part of it.
It's like, yeah, you know, everybody that you know might say they're going to write a book or they're going to make a movie,
exactly.
But they've done it, right?
They've done it.
And you're part of it. How's that feel?
Pretty awesome. Really excited. And I'm really honored to be asked to be a part of it.
And how'd you get involved?
Well, I've known Pat and Randall just for, you know, a couple years. No, long time.
How many years?
Well, what was it? We did a show with Soundstage Productions in 2005, yeah. 6, wow. 2004. So that was the first time I got to work with them. So this is kind of a neat reunion show feel to this.
That's
so
great.
It's so exciting. The tickets are on sale right now, and we're working on helping broadcast this to the whole wide world.
When I am too afraid to
doesn't that just make you want to
I know it makes you want to sing, because you've always wanted to sing.
Don't make me sing. We should wear this to their premiere.
Absolutely, yeah. We're going to be doing the red carpet
interviews
and stuff. It's going to be a big splashy thing. I'm so excited about
that. World premiere. Because no one's done it before, so.
It's almost as exciting as our big news. Do you think it's time? There was a time that Lisa and I just, well, she had a dream.
You should do it like Wayne's
World,
but.
It's a little late, though. There's like a pause, and then you tell me to do it.
Doug, I had a crazy dream.
What?
Close your eyes.
Okay,
we were on a stage.
Right.
There was puppets, and there was singers, and dancers, and musicians, and we were interviewing people.
Lisa, it's not a dream. It's real. Except for maybe the puppets. The puppets. I don't know if the puppets are confirmed. I like puppets too.
I like puppets. So.
Maybe somebody out there can help us with puppets. Any puppeteers around? Coming this summer, well, Lisa's dream comes true. We've got a stage, we've got a fantastic space for an audience, we've got, well, a winery to serve.
A vibrant winery
to serve food and drink, and all of that will be an amazing time.
That's right, coming this summer at the Vibrant Vine Winery. Doug, I'm so excited.
It's gonna be awesome. We're gonna be live on location, multi-camera, up on stage, a variety talk entertainment show that we invite the whole town to come out
the
and
world.
Enjoy.
The no, world. We invite the whole world.
The whole world. Anybody that's nearby can come.
Yes. Fly in.
It's going to be on the grass in front of the Vibrant Vine. There's a stage there.
Saturdays, 1 to 4.
Saturdays from 1 to 4. A great afternoon, a great family afternoon of entertainment, fun, and the taping of a live TV show, which should be awesome.
Yes.
And we got all sorts of incredible people helping us out with
Lucy.
This. Lucy Hazelwood from Lukey Dance Productions will be getting the audience up and moving and interacting and providing some of the great dancing.
Yeah, and we also have Carrie and Carrie from Global Adventure Center. They'll be doing different challenges each week with some local businesses involved in the sporting and adventure.
That's going to be good. And Bonnie Gratz from New Vintage Theater is helping us line up some of the best actors in the Valley that'll be putting on performances and talking about upcoming productions. Great way to find out more about like live theatrical shows that are going on.
Yeah.
It's going to be your source for everything fun this summer. And come out and join us. You can get all the information on our Facebook page, facebook.com/DougAndLisa.
Show.
And if you want to, if you'd like to be involved, if you are an entertainer, or if you've got some technical skills, or if you'd like to learn some technical skills, we'll teach you. We want to have a great crew that's going to have a great time.
And if you're a winery, cidery, brewery, or distillery, it's not just the Vibrant Vine Winery that will be featured.
That's right. We want to reach out to anybody in the Valley in that incredible industry. We met some of you earlier on the show.
And we want you back.
We want you to come back. Sit down with us. Tell us about your story. It's going to be a regular segment every week. Thanks for watching. See you next time.
Yeah. Now this is just our banter where we talk, where the credits are going over.
Right.
Blah, blah, blah. Oh, look at this.
Yes, that's good.
Fancy Doug behind the scenes.
Fancy Doug behind the scenes.
That's what it's
Fancy
called.
Lisa.
We need 11 viewers for that.
Yeah.
That's going to be fun to edit.
Lol.
What? The Doug and Lisa Show is a community volunteer production. We'd like to thank all of the people and businesses for their continuing support. If you'd like to learn more about sponsorship and advertising opportunities, contact us at
DougAndLisaShow@gmail.com. While we wait for our $1 billion check from Dragon's Den.
What? Have you heard something?
No, but I'm still waiting for them to call.
Right, okay, yeah. So, while we're waiting.
For the $1 billion.
Here's your chance to get on the ground floor.